Unrest and anger as Israeli lawmakers undertake a seismic shift in the nation's democratic foundation.
We were left with no choice but to go to nonviolent disobedience, and we're here to protect our democracy with our bodies.
Demonstrators chained themselves to whatever they could, including each other, blocking the road to the Knesset. Ahead of Monday's vote to remove the Supreme Court's ability to strike down government rules based on reasonability, tens of thousands marched on Jerusalem.
I'm so, so sad. I'm here for 3 days protesting and do everything I can.
Inside the Israeli parliament, the opposition yelled shame and walked out. Benjamin Netanyahu's government rests on the shoulders of a far-right coalition, giving his side the numbers to pass the contentious bills. Devoted friends, Canada and the U.S. urge the Israeli prime minister to seek broader consensus before going ahead with the reforms.
How far is the degradation of the judiciary in Israel going to go? It is not yet clear.
The legislation is just one element of a larger judicial overhaul package put on hold in the face of fierce opposition, though Netanyahu also faced pressure to act or risk losing his coalition. He now says he's willing to discuss the next phases. As night fell, more demonstrations and more clashes with police, this time in Tel Aviv. Both sides used the Israeli flag as their symbol as judicial reforms have divided the nation. The issue has even resulted in thousands of Israeli Defense Force reservists threatening to not show up for duty.
A weaker Supreme Court could make it easier for the government to build more Israeli settlements in occupied territories, something Netanyahu's far-right coalition has already pledged to do. The change could also help the prime minister. He still faces corruption charges. An opposition party has already filed a court challenge on the judicial reforms legislation. Donna?
All right, Crystal Gamansing in London tonight. Thanks.